All right, engineers, we're going to take a look at the femur now. So if we look at the femur, this is actually the posterior view of the femur. Okay, so if we look here, this is actually the head of the femur. Again, it's made with, it has articular cartilage or hyaline cartilage surrounding it so that it can articulate with the acetabulum of the coxibone to form the synovial bone socket joint. If you look here, these are some really big things that are popping out here. This is actually called the greater trochanter. All right, and this one down here is the lesser trochanter. And there's kind of like this crest moving between them. So this is called the intertrochanteric crest. So again, greater trochanter, lesser trochanter, intertrochanteric crest. If you look right here, this is actually going to be referred to as the gluteal tuberosity. That's where the gluteal muscles attach to. All right, they actually insert in that point right there. Then if I move down here, you can see the linea aspera. This is the linea aspera, it's a kind of an attachment for some of the hamstring muscles. Then if I come down here, this is actually called the lateral supracondylar line right there. And this is the medial supracondylar line right there. So again, medial supracondylar line, lateral supracondylar line. I'm gonna keep moving down here. And then these are gonna be our condyles down here. So this is actually the medial condyle right here. This is the lateral condyle, and this little space in here is called the intercondylar fossa. Now, if you look over here, there is, again, these little condyles over here. This is actually the medial epicondyle. All right, so that's the medial epicondyle. What's important about the medial epicondyles is actually a little tubercle right above it. There's actually a little tubercle right above that medial epicondyle, and that's called the adductor tubercle. That's where some of the adductor muscles attach right there. Okay, now if I come over here, we take a look over here, that's our lateral epicondyle. So that's a lateral epicondyle. All right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to flip it over, and we're going to look at the anterior side. All right, again, so now we're looking at the anterior side of the femur. Again, this is the head of the femur. Now, if you saw before, there was a big crest before. Now it kind of just looks like a really, like, less prominent crest. It's actually called the intertrochanteric line. And it's this little part right there. It's the intertrochanteric line. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to move down the shaft of the femur here, or the diaphysis, and then we're going to come down here to the distal epiphyses. All right, so if we look here, this little divot in here, it's actually where the patella bone, which is a sesamoid bone, sits in there. It's called the patellar surface right there. All right, guys, so now we're going to take a look at two more things I want to point out, and that's right here. You can actually see a little divot in there. It's actually called the fovea capitis. Called the fovea capitis there. Some ligaments actually attach from that to the acetabulum of the coxibone. Then if you look again, the way I'm holding my fingers around this part of the femur, the way that I'm holding it, that what I'm wrapping around is the surgical neck of the femur. All right, guys, so that pretty much covers everything we need to know about the femur.